I'm Gabriella Gobbi. I'm associate professor at the Department of Psychiatry of McGill University. I'm a staff psychiatrist at the Mood Disorder Clinic of McGill University Health Center. My experience that led me to work in the area of mental health is a long journey. I think it was a sort of a calling or a sort of a vocation. In fact, when I was 13 years old, I stopped reading Mickey Mouse magazine and I started reading the interpretation of dreams by Freud. And at this point, start my interest in psychology and psychoanalysis. Then, during my secondary school, I was very interested in neurobiology. And at that point, I decided to go to medical school. During medical school, I started to do some research, and the research was for me the part more innovative, more creative of medicine, when you can ask the right question and have the right answer. But I think that my research in psychopharmacology is helping people that suffering from mental health. Just to give you an example, 60 years ago, people suffering from bipolar disorder were destined to spend their life in a psychiatric hospital or asylum. Today we have many treatments for bipolar disorder, so people can be treated with drugs as well with psychotherapy, and they can have a normal life, they can get married, have children. I have patients that are teachers, lawyers, doctors, entrepreneurs, so they can really have a fulfillment in their life. So I think that psychopharmacology and the research to find novel drugs can still help a lot of people to have a decent life, a normal life, and finally to bring more happiness in their life. My greatest accomplishment in my career, I can say, were the Eureka moment, when my laboratory really discovered something new. I think the first was in 2002, when we discovered that some drug that enhance the endocannabinoid, the natural cannabis in the brain, have a potent antidepressant effect. Another moment was also when we were the first laboratory to discover the mechanism linking adolescent cannabis consumption with depression. And this research had a big impact because also influenced the governmental policy about cannabis and young people. This Sam Lal Award means a lot for me. First, because even if I never discussed with Sam Lal, I didn't have this possibility, but I know that Sam Lal was a pioneer and a big fan in translational psychiatry. He really believed that it's important to have basic research close to clinical work, because basic research can bring new therapy, innovation for patients, and also vice versa. Patients can bring new questions for research that research has to answer. The second reason why I'm very proud to receive this prize is because for the first time was awarded to a woman. And I hope that this prize can encourage new young women to enter in the field of research in mental health. Indeed, in the last years, I met several young women, very intelligent, with a strong background in research and medicine, that decided to abandon research because of thinking that it's not possible to conciliate family and work. But it's true, research is extremely demanding for a woman, requiring a lot of sacrifice, a lot of devotion, but must not be a reason to abandon research. In particular, in mental research, we need women because women have empathy, have compassion, are care, are bright. So I hope in the future to have more women.